Hi,
how are you?
Girl, you've got to update moi. Go.
So what's happening now? You know, I joined a couple of sites, social sites, just it got boring with this pandemic. I said, let me just join, see what's out there. You know, since I was still single, I'm not. But I'm giving one young fella, he's about 58, I'm 61. I'm giving him some time. He's from California. In business for himself. He sells minerals, stones, and it trades in for gold, which is real interesting. I mean, I looked it up. It's like, and he sent me two dozens of flowers a couple days ago, along with HelloFresh, $80 gift certificate.
And what else did he do? Honey, what are we talking about right now? Why are we on the phone talking?
I'm trying to figure out. You know, he's so far. He's in California.
Where is he in California?
Oh, boy. He gave me the name of the city. But I know he told me it was like at least a couple hundred miles from where the fires are starting. Okay. And he has a son that's in Florida. And his wife actually deceased in a car accident 2 years ago. So he's a widower. Yeah. He's good to talk to. He really treats me like a queen.
Yeah.
Wanda, so, you know.
I like this. Like, I'm not for nothing. I'm just watching your energy right now, honey. And you like this guy. And I can see it and feel it. And I know you're nervous because he's in Cali. That's what I can tell.
He's in Cali. He has his late meetings. He has his friend, Alan, that he meets a lot with. And Alan gives him referrals. So, you know, I try to do a lookup, a search, because I'm always curious about searches. My girlfriend a while back, she did a search and she couldn't believe the stuff that was in the background of this young man, mm-hmm. including incarceration. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And I couldn't find anything on him. I found nothing on him. So I don't know. I pray a lot and I ask God, I said, God, please close the doors for me if they're not for me. Because I tell you, the games and just the talk and this stuff that goes on, you know, as far as gaming, mm-hmm. I have to really kind of listen. And I have to listen because the games are out there.
Oh, I know, girl. Well, and here's the thing too. Couple key nuggets for you that you're going to be equally as psyched and bummed about, I think, at the same time. It's bittersweet. Okay, bittersweet. That's a better word.
Okay.
Here's the first thing. Number one is that you are going to fall in love again. Here's the good part. You're going to fall in love again, and it's actually going to be better than more mature than it was the first time. The bittersweet part, it's really not bad. It's just different. It's going to feel different, though, to you. So I think where we kind of trick ourselves as adults is like, okay, well, I'm waiting. I'll know because I knew when it was that time. And so I'm waiting for something similar.
Right.
I feel that shift. But the reality is you are a different person now than you were then.
Oh, absolutely.
No, and he is too. And also, this is a different environment. And so I see people miss opportunities because they're thinking it's going to feel a certain way when in reality, we just need to position ourselves in a certain place to receive that kind of energy. And mainly men, and it's funny, you mentioned guys being aggressive. If they're aggressive, it's because they don't know what to do, these poor guys. They're just like, someone say weird things, and other ones are scammers, and other ones are just straight up gross.
Mm-hmm.
But you're right. It is easy for a guy to wine and dine you virtually across state lines. Like, that is easy breezy lemon squeezy. You could be
sure it is,
right? So, are there other flags about him or things other than the fact that he's in California that you find unattractive, or is that really the main bottleneck? That's really the main blocker for you guys to potentially even consider something else?
Well, I haven't met him face-to-face. And face-to-face says a lot. You know, you can talk on the phone.
Have you done this?
I hate doing Zoom. I don't like that. And I hate myself on camera. This one here, on Zoom, and I just don't like it. You know what I mean? It's like, my makeup didn't look like that. Picture's too dark. Even now, this one, it's too dark. You know, I can't really see my features.
Girl, I'll help you with that, though. But that's an easy fix, though, because here's a couple things. One, there's a beauty filter that most women don't know about, and I will send you the article, and you just turn it on, and it gives you a little zhuzhi, and it's so nice.
Mm.
Which is nice for me, because I don't have good skin. I have breakout a lot, so I need
that. You look amazing. So it smooths everything out, huh?
helps a lot. It helps a lot. And then two, and I'll give you some tips on lighting, but this is an easy fix. Like even right now in your worst lighting, as you call it, you're stunning. Like seriously.
Thank you.
So I'm not worried about that. But the reason I ask about the video chat is because that's your fastest way to figure out if this thing's real or not. I mean, that's real. Any guy that's, and also his response to it, if he's weird about it, get out of there. Like, why would he be weird about a video chat, you know?
I can move forward with that, though. I wouldn't have a problem with it.
Okay, so I think the first question we ask ourselves, is this guy really somebody that is hitting you in the right way? Like, if he weren't in California right now, if that's the only block, would you consider him? If that's the case, then initiate a video chat. I would definitely consider.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how you'll... That's
I would consider.
That's how you'll figure out if there's anything more even worth considering. Yeah, but if you've already written him off because he's too far and you're just not into it, that's okay too. Just let him know that. But just ask mm-hmm. yourself that question. Like, what do you want? Like, do you want to explore and see how it goes? Because here's the good thing. That's what we do is vet people. Like, we vet daters.
Mm.
Run checks on daters because people need help figuring out how real people are. So, like, before people go out on dates, we run a little checky. And, like, even with this guy, like, we would run a check on him and then in 48 hours I'll send it back with whatever we have. It's designed to help people just feel way more confident and secure about who they're dating so they can fall for people locally if possible, but if not possible, then at least not locally, then at least vetted. At least they've talked to another human. At least they've gotten a check run on them.
You know. That's a wonderful thing. I don't think a lot of social sites like this do that.
Nobody does. We run date checks on all of your dates. That way, whoever you decide to engage with, you can feel confident about, you know, more information than...
That's awesome. I'm impressed. Yes, it is important.
I think this is important for you anyway, just for your own safety, my love, all jokes aside. I think the fact that you're dating these guys, I think that's important. And you having a partner that you can just kind of have your back and making sure that they're just legit.
Absolutely. So nice talking with you and enlightening me on a few things that I needed to hear.
Yeah, this will give me a lot of relief to know who I'm talking to.
Yes, girl. If you have any questions, you just reach out, let me know. Book a time with me. We got you.
I can't wait.
Okay.